Hey guys, I want to talk briefly this week about an issue that I experienced personally with my mom, is the changing eating habits of a loved one who is diagnosed with Alzheimer's or dementia. It's been really interesting to see my mom's taste buds change as the disease has progressed, and her interest in food to sort of dwindle down to nothing. I think for some patients, that part of the brain that signals hunger or thirst, those connections start to get a little bit lost. And so my mom really never expresses the fact that she's thirsty or hungry, which is very different than she was before. She loved her pastas and her carbs and her white wine, and now it's difficult to get her to eat anything. So I want to share three things that I've been doing with my mom to help make eating less of a battle in our household. And the first tip came from Sylvia, a caretaker who helped us when Dad got sick, and she suggested using smaller plates, smaller spoons, smaller bowls with my mom so that it looks like a smaller portion of food. It made a lot of sense to me because my mom seems to have issues with depth perception. She'll look at something and in her brain it looks really big and really overwhelming and she gets very anxious. So I took Sylvia's suggestion and I started using the smallest bowl that I could find to put her yogurt in and a little spoon that's actually a coffee spoon. And what do you know, it has worked for us. So that's one thing that you could definitely try with your loved one. Second thing that I started doing was really hard for me. In the beginning, I pushed and I pushed. And it became a battle between the two of us every day. And there was tension and conflict and it was not good. I felt like I had to push food on her and drinks on her, so much so. And at one point said, stop it. It was out of concern and out of love, making sure that she wasn't dehydrated and wanting to make sure that she was getting enough protein and getting her veggies. But I look back on it now and I think to myself, well, I don't like being told when to eat and what to eat. So why would she be any different? So I backed off. Really, I backed off almost completely. And this suggestion came from a hospice nurse. She suggested instead of going in there and ordering her to drink this Ensure that I was trying to get her to drink, she said, why don't you just go in, have the Ensure in your hand, put it on her side table, set it down and say, you know, just in case you get thirsty, it's here for you, and then walk away. Guess what? Every single time when I put that Ensure down on her bedside, she drinks it. And just backing off of the conflict and not forcing her. Which brings me to my last point. Here's the thing. My mom is not gonna live much longer. And that's hard for me to wrap my brain around and hard to accept. At the same time, I want her to find as much joy as she possibly can. And if it is in buttered noodles every single night without fail, I am going to feed her buttered noodles every single night. And this is something, again, that the hospice nurses have told me time and time again. Give your mom what she wants. Let her enjoy. Let her lead. If she wants chocolate chip cookies for breakfast, give it to her. If she wants ice cream for dinner, okay, at least she's eating something. It's so hard as a caretaker to know if you're doing the right thing most of the time. And the best advice that I think I've been given by multiple people who have gone through a similar situation is, they always tell me, listen to what your loved one has to say and let them lead. Let me know if you found this video helpful by hitting the like button down below or maybe sharing with someone who you think could use this video. As always, stay strong, stay grateful, and stay present. I'll see you next time.